iDiskiTV powered by World Sports Betting. Sao Tome and Principe 2, Bafana Bafana 4 in an African Cup of Nations qualifier. Before we start the conversation with Tso Vilakazi, of course, the second edition of iDiski Times is out on Tuesday. It will be only be 3.50. We spoke to Kabatinio Mango. I spoke to Gert Skalkweg. We interviewed a lot of people in that edition. Desiree Ellis, for example, Sipiwe Shabalala. It will be available in 2,000 shops across the country, and it will be available in English and isiZulu as well. Get yourself the copy, and if you want to know more information about the paper, you can go to iDiskiTimes.co.za, www.iDiskiTimes.co.za. A lot of you have already opened your profiles there. You've already been pushing your articles and your thoughts as well, sharing your thoughts on the website. So we thank you very much for that. So we saw a game, and I think the feedback, Sao Tome scored first, and we didn't expect that. And then we answered with two goals, and then they scored a goal, and then we thought it was going to fizzle out into a draw. I think the underlying thing is just the way in which we approach this game against a smaller country, a country that has so many problems, that they had to play their home game in Port Elizabeth, which is not their home.
I'm worried. I'm very, very worried. Gulego, if it's so pazamiswa a country I wonder by 200,000, with a face aganjan Egypt, with a face aganjan Africa Coast. I'm talking about Tangeti City, a big country, level high. But now, if man also die in a country, if I'm an alien, and then you can't even score 5 goals. No, man, Gulego. Something is wrong. I don't know. Maybe Yimi Engbona Ngendela Yamuguti. Maybe some people babona ngeyabindlela, but Kulego, we can have play. I will make an example, manch. Even like Kaya, if an amateur team plays with a professional team, mm-hmm. You can see a difference.
Yes, sir.
Amateur team, good. Like Kaya, amateur team, it's a professional team, you can see a difference. Mm-hmm. Iyenzakele lento le, Sundowns yashaya enye team as power lines lapana 24. It tells you what the mass Gulego, Melek Monagalo, you are a professional club, a professional country, you are here. These teams are mentioned here. You show by a local grounding. So Tina, Sibonise Laban Labo, like Sialingan Gulego, these people are gonna play against Ghana, gonna play against Sudan. I'm worried, Gulego, when we're gonna play against Sudan, against Ghana, mm-hmm. If so, Korong, I must set place, Ganj. Gulego, we still have a long way to go. And that's why I'm worried, because the whole defense, but I'm Premier League, but I'm going League. Week in, week out, these guys are playing. But they do the very same mistake. So I don't know what coach wetu uple na kanjani team yake, and you know that's why I'm worried Nkulego, ngoba there's for example Ukopo lapane pension. I know him very well. I grew up I know what coaching yake injani, and now manga mbona lapane pension, and looking at our team they will dlanga, but our team Nkulego, it doesn't have a structure. They just play with when a team in Yako that full peg of going up. Now Udala Lena, when a team Yako they meet Lilin Dalaranjan, no Minangene boxing, okay, now Lazo Dalaranjan. No. There must be a different model like Tapinako national team. There must be a structure of national team to Guti, Silaranjan. Look today, Dalango Zungu no Lontuzana, no 10 Fairmen. I understand whether we were playing 4-2-4 or we were playing 4-3-3 or I understand. Mm-hmm. So it tells you what my problems with Manning. Mm-hmm.
All right, just to give you an idea, if you didn't have the privilege of watching the actual game, Sao Tome scored the first goal. It was from a corner. And then South Africa responded. A good pass by Mshishi Zwane or by Tin Furman to Themba Zwane as well. I can't remember who scored the second goal, but it was a good goal as well. And then Sao Tome scored from a set piece again, a headed goal. There were two Sao Tome players who were free, who scored a free header, even in the first goal as well. You see the score line, it was not broadcast, the match was not broadcast live, you look at 4-2 and you think it was a very good game. But actually, the two goals that were scored by South Africa to make it 4-2 were scored in the last 10 minutes of the game when the game was fizzling out. And you could see, Uchi, this is an amateur team, really. And you could see the quality. But for the most part, for 80 minutes, you couldn't tell which is South Africa and which is Sao Tome. And I think that's really the problem as well. Well done to Themba Zwane for scoring two goals. Good performance, or at least good for you for scoring two goals, because really, it wasn't much of a good performance in terms of connecting and combining as well. Let's look at the individual performances. I think I gave my feelings on Kick and Dolly was that, look, he's not able to combine with his team well. He's off the pace a little bit as well. Of course, obviously, Manyama will always be a challenge because he finds it very difficult to take on people. What did you make of the individual performances on some of the players as well?
Kuleko, before ngizo yakwenda ka Dolly. You know, mangibona ama sub ka coach, I was so disappointed, very disappointed. Umanyama is not a striker. That's number one. You play Umanyama as a striker, you've got Udurasang Ukona no Erasmus. Nkuleko, you know, as a player, I've been a player. As a player, somebody come to your position and is not doing well in your position, psychologically akushaya now. You lose your confidence. Now you start to believe, you know, it means the coach doesn't believe in me. And then by the time you've been given a chance, you've got all those negative thoughts in your mind. Mm-hmm. Of which, I'm not saying it's wrong. It's right, because a coach maga selector in your position as a striker, he needs to play you there. And if he selector me as an attacking midfielder, he must play me there. You cannot select me as an attacking midfielder and then you're going to play me wide. So ubulala confidence here. So ubulala confidence ka Manyama, ubulala confidence ka Erasmus na Ludasang. You see, ma'am, Gulego, it's very important when you need your players to go in and perform well, is to play them where they are comfortable in the positions. Because when you select a player, we select according to who comfortable in this position. Kigen Toli, second half it was much better. You could see, you know, that pace. You can see, you know, 1v1, try to take them on. But overall, Nkuleko, I'm born with him. Injury is as a corner. Guye Ngondweni, I was injured. And, you know, Agaga Funungena, you know, in those 50-50 where he can say, you know what, Minaki can do, I can take you on now. Normally, I need to track and go to you guys. But he's gonna come, Kulego. He's gonna come because you could see what he's trying than a player who doesn't try anything. So he's trying. So I just wish Guti, you know, he can maybe get somebody that will help him psychologically to overcome the injury arc, because he's a very good player.
Yeah. In terms of going forward with the coaching team that we have, I mentioned this during the friendly matches, Namibia and Zambia, that no association is gonna make a decision to fire a coach after 4 matches at the time. It's now 6 matches, and I'm not saying anything about being fired. I'm just saying, just giving context to what I'm about to ask you now. Where are we going with this coaching team? Tso Vilakazi, Coach Kopo, no Coach Molefenseki, who's the head coach. I asked this question because I asked you on Friday as well. Where are we going in terms of how are we playing? Are we a counter-pressing or a pressing team? Are we a team that shares the ball on the ground and moving it with speed? Are we a team that relies on long balls? Where are we going? Are we getting a sense that siyaphambili okanye semva with regards to how we are playing?
Nkuleko, you know, I'm a bit confused, ngoba I'm going to understand you and the team in a structure. Because if the team in a structure, it's easier for you to see. Our team, and I told you that, whether we want to do a build-up from the back and surprise our opponents by playing the switch balls, or are we playing with in terms of when we switch them and then we cross, get somebody there as a target man to head and score goals. I'm a bit confused because when we go wide, we're trying to stretch the defense. But now, I'm worried when we cross those balls. How are we crossing them? High and low, backwards, in the air for somebody that can hit. I don't know. Because our play, we've got ball players. You know, we can do build up That's one thing that I've seen. Ukuthi, when it comes to sharing the ball, we can share. And then all of a sudden, we just want to switch. Even when we're not ready to switch to another side, but we're just playing it. At some point, it happened, Ukuthi, the coach was shouting to switch.
Yes, Kumurena.
And then we end up losing the ball. Yeah. And then we had five players there. So that's why our coach wants us to share, and then switch the ball. Mm-hmm. But I must be in a good position to switch that ball. We understand. But Tina, a minute the coach says this, and then now I decide to do that. I'm not ready. I'm not in a good position that I can really switch that ball. And again, I don't know whether because sometimes I'm asking again, Ukuthi, our midfielders, do we have one that will go inside the box, or both of them they must stay outside? Because in this game, there were actions where I would say we needed one midfielder inside the box.
Yep.
One midfielder inside the box, just to add a number on that. But you'll find both of them on the outside. Mm. And then we end up losing a ball, even though we're not supposed to lose the ball. Mm. But because of the numbers, we can't every time rely on Themba Zwane. That's what we're doing. Themba Zwane, we rely on him. He must be the one carrying inside the box. Must be the one. What are they doing in these other players? Mm. Because we've got with two wingers are there. We've got a striker. Themba Zwane has got that freedom.
Yeah.
So if Themba Zwane doesn't go inside the box, it means we don't have anyone.
Mm.
So you two, what are you doing? Both of you sitting. At least let's have one of you going also to help. Because, you know, by going inside the box late, you can win us games.
Mm.
All right. Tournament football, it looks like we may qualify. Whatever happens, I think when we're playing against Sudan, I think to be on the safe side, all we need to do is to have a point against them, because Sudan appears to be losing both of their matches against Ghana. So by the time they're playing against us, we are leading them by 6 points. So if we get a point against them, then we are in a good position, you know, and head-to-head will help us. It looks like we may be going to the African Cup of Nations in Cameroon next year, which is a good thing for us. I think the bigger conversation then is, how are we performing there? In 2019, we were knocked out by Nigeria in the quarterfinals. We didn't really play well. We were number three in the group stages. We could have been knocked out, but we were at least on goal difference. We qualified ngendlela nje ngebackdoor because we were one of the best number threes. In 2015, under coach Sheikh Mashaba, we were out in the group stages. We were defeated by Ghana, Senegal, and I think Algeria as well, if I'm not mistaken. So it's like bad performances. We're going to Algeria. To Cameroon, by the looks of things now. What are your concerns going to that tournament? I know we still have maybe one or two matches to play, I think two matches, but it looks like we are going now. What are your concerns going to that tournament?
Nguleko, I'm very concerned because it's the same thing in Aisho when we are playing two friendly games. You play two friendly games against Namibia, against Zambia. There were no core of the team in those two games. And then you come now, qualifiers of the AFCON. Now you've got these other players that we want them to take us to Cameroon, of which so far, so good, they did very well. But in Kulego, if you don't plan, you're not gonna achieve your goal. You need to sit down and plan. If you plan to go to Cameroon and you plan Ukuthi wanna go to Africa Cup of, go quarterfinals, semifinal, or get to the final,
yeah,
you need to start and plan now. But the way we played the past two games, Kuleka, I don't see us going to the knockout stages, because a country in Abandaba 200, a country in a semi professional football, you call us part of the second range. Because right now, Mina, I believe we win Lama game now too. So I win it because of individual brilliance of the players, not because of Ubonuguti. I know La. I have a fan of a coach. You,
yeah,
you could see the play here, but they build up towards the goal.
Mm-hmm.
You could see good. Bonala, he planned from the coach.
Yeah.
This is how the coach wants the team to play. No. But it was individual from the players. And yes, in football, you need that individual brilliance. But we want to see the team plays. We want to see all those players to play. Baba, my team players. We don't need individual. Individual, we need it when it's very, very hard, where we need to grind.
Yeah.
Then that's where we'll ask, okay, individual, can you give us something? But overall, we just need team players.
Mm-hmm. All right, there you go. iDiskiTimes is out. The second edition of iDiskiTimes is out for 3 rand 50 only. You'll find the paper in isiZulu and English as well, online at Maxta and in 2,000 shops around the country as well. We thank you very much for supporting us in our first edition. iDiskiTimes.co.za. iDiskiTV is on Facebook. We're flighting this game live. A lot of people watched it. Over 50,000 people were watching throughout that match. And then, of course, World Sports Betting, wsb.co.za. Thank you very much for watching us.